Hey guys, Garry Dean. I've been asked probably six or seven times this week, what do I keep in my truck? What's the updated mobile unit situation? And as most of you guys know, and I've got other spinoff videos I'll do on the same subject, I use far less equipment and get far more done than most detailers do. And, you know, that's kind of like my role in the industry is to try to help you guys use less to get better results and to be more efficient. And, you know, I don't use a carpet extractor. I think they're bullshit. They're worthless, in my opinion. They just wake up the soiling instead of completely removing it. And I'll do a video on that and the different methods of shampooing. Like, you know, I prefer a damp shampoo method over the extraction, or I'll gut the interior and pressure wash. So it's either damp shampoo or gut the interior. So the bottom line is, I want to show you guys what I take on mobile jobs. I can tell you, and I'll preface this video right now with, I have never, ever, ever, ever been in a situation where I showed up to a client's house or office building where a power outlet was available and water was available, where they minded at all that I use their water and power. I generally do not bring water and power anywhere I go. It's just, you know, I'll make sure on the phone call that they know I'll need to use their water and power. But the other thing is, I'm not using a lot of power, and I'm definitely not using a lot of water, especially if I'm using the Garry Dean wash method, which is a rinseless wash method, where I use only a gallon of water per car to wash a vehicle, which is pretty cool. Check that out in the other videos. Just Google search the Garry Dean wash method if you've not seen that. But again, I use far less of everything than most detailers, and I get a lot more done, which means I can make more money in a day by getting more done. But, you know, none of it's even worth it or has any value unless you're making the customer happy. And that's the situation that you have to make sure happens, is if you're using less products, fewer products, fewer pieces of equipment and all that, that's cool. But as long as the end result is that you're making your customers happy, that's what matters. So without further ado, I'm going to take you into the back of my truck, and I'm going to show you what I take on mobile jobs. And I'm also going to give you a couple of different options for a couple extra things you might want to think about taking. So I didn't lay it out. I generally will lay all my stuff out, but we'll just go through it while it's in the truck. As you can see, it's all nicely organized there. First thing is, this is pretty amazing for getting up on low, you know, to stand on, to get up a little bit higher than you would on your feet. But it's also really awesome to sit on when you're doing wheels and tires. I also bring a kneeling pad. Now, if you're doing wheels and tires and you're going to be there for a while, putting this kneeling pad on top of the little stool here is definitely beneficial on your butt. So you can kneel on this, put your knees on that, or you can sit on it on top of the collapsible stool. It's pretty cool. I got that stool, I believe, for $15 at Ace Hardware. This right here, this kneeling pad, I think I got this at Home Depot or Lowe's. It's like $2 or $3 in the gardening section. Biggest benefit to this stool is that it's extremely functional and it takes up very little space. I always carry a 25-foot extension cord. This one's brand new. I just bought it. My other one fell apart. I actually upgraded and got a medium duty instead of the light duty I've been using. The light duty ones last me a couple years. I figured this would last me a lot longer, and this was roughly half the price of the next step up, which was a contractor grade. This was like $20. I just bought it at Lowe's. It is just a 14 gauge extension cord. Pretty cool. This bag has my microfiber towels in it. It's breathable, but it doesn't let any dirt or anything in. It's a laundry bag, I got this laundry bag on Amazon. I also use the larger version to keep the rest of my towels in. But I literally keep all my towels in here. Give you a peek in there. I just have a bunch of random towels in there. I just keep everything in there. So towels, Amazon.com for this laundry bag. Just search laundry bags and you can pretty much get them in any color. As you guys know, I love the Rigid portable vac, the 5 horsepower, 4 gallon. I think this thing is $90 at Home Depot. This is the best vacuum I've ever had. This is actually my third one in the 15 years I've been doing this. So they last a good long while, and it makes me happy, does a good job, so I continue to buy them. Another thing about that vacuum is you need the pro hose. The hose it comes with is not long enough, and it is not durable enough for professional use. So get the optional pro hose when it comes to the Rigid portable vac. And that's actually located right next to the vacuum. I believe the pro hose kit with the different ends and stuff like that is gonna be about $35, I'm pretty sure. Next we have my polisher bag. Now, I had another polisher in here and I gotta locate it and put it back in here. But I generally keep 2 Harbor Freight DAs, one of which has my 5.5-inch backing plate, and then the other one will be for my 4-inch pads and my 3.5-inch backing plate. I sell the backing plates on detailjuice.com. I keep my cord control clip in there, which is a pretty amazing situation. I use an extension cord on a polisher. I just tape it together. I keep masking tape. I actually prefer the Rust-Oleum. You can get this stuff at Walmart. It's pretty awesome. This is in the automotive section. So, and then like I said, I keep another polisher with the small backing plate on it, a couple of flashlights down there, extra batteries, and then I keep this little Sterilite container that I got from Walmart in there as well, and it holds my pads. I use the Buff and Shine 4-inch orange pads for my headlight restorations, which is why I keep that small backing plate and that polisher in the bag as well. I also only use Buff and Shine pads. I exclusively use those because I have found that not only do they work the best, but they are the most durable on the market. So I just have a few of them in there right now. I always keep a headlamp in there as well for checking my results for paint correction. So just a little kit. I keep some sandpaper and stuff like that too in the pockets. I keep 1,000, 1,500, and then 2,000, 2,500 grit sandpaper in the pockets for headlight restoration as well, and for, you know, sanding scratches down. I keep 2 buckets in here, 2 3.5-gallon buckets. I don't like the 5-gallon buckets. They're just too big, especially if you're only using a gallon per car. So 2 buckets, one of which has a Gamma Seal lid. I don't really use the Gamma Seal lid because I don't seal anything in there, and my brushes extend past the top. I use a variety of wheel woolies. This is a cheap Chinese brush I use for lug nuts. This is a hard bristle brush I use for tires. This is a fantastic boar's hair brush. This is also from Braun Brush, the people who make the wheel woolies. This is amazing for wheel faces and that kind of thing. It really is soft, but it really is effective at cleaning. I've got a couple tire dressing applicators for my transform dressing for when I apply tire gel. I keep another hard bristle brush for carpets. I have a boar's hair brush, a very, very fine boar's hair brush I use for interior leather. I always keep an extra sprayer around. That's a good idea. Another wheel woolly. I keep this fancy brush. I don't know where I got it. I never use this thing ever. I keep my clay bar in a little baggie here. I keep a couple of new bars with me as well. They're probably in my product container right there. So anyway, clay bar. This is a brush. It's a medium bristle brush that I put on my DA for just random stuff, mostly boats and stuff. I keep pieces of Doodlebug, which is a 3M product for chrome and that kind of thing. That's an abrasive pad that finishes really well, so keep some of that around. Always keep an extra flashlight here and there. You never know when you're going to lose a flashlight or need one. Phillips head screwdriver. Now that is beneficial in many, many, many ways for detailing. Always got to keep your Phillips head screwdriver. Trust me, if you don't have one in your detailing arsenal, you are not doing yourself any justice. Two buckets, all that stuff, good stuff, lots of different brushes. I just keep it all inside the bucket for storage and for transportation purposes. So that's that. I usually keep a three-step ladder. It's important to have a three-step ladder, in my opinion, but I've been carrying this two-step ladder, and it's been doing everything I needed to do. If I were working on my truck, I would need the three-step ladder. However, it's in my garage, and I don't feel like grabbing it. This one was convenient when I had to leave the other day, so I grabbed it. It works fine. I prefer the three-step. Like I said, I have a three-step, but this two-step works well as well. I just replaced this after about 7 years. My other one went bad. I got this reel, and I guess you call it a extension or a strip cord power deal from Lowe's. I just bought it today. I believe it was $14. The cool part about it is the extension cord does not come with it. This is just a cheap 16 gauge 100 foot extension, just in case I need to go farther with power than my 25 foot will allow. I believe the vacuum also has 25 feet, so combined you've got at least 40 to 50 feet of extension, but you never want to be without a 100 foot extension just in case. This is the second setup I had. Like I said, I've had the other one for years and years and years, and this 16 gauge extension has never been not enough thickness or whatever to transfer the power that distance, especially when I'm using just one polisher or just the vacuum. It works just fine. So the benefit to this is not only can you plug in the extension cord with this, which I have it run through here just for transportation, transport situation. But you've got four outlets there, and you've got a breaker, which is pretty cool. So if it trips a breaker, you hit that, and then you got power again. So anyway, that's cool. I literally just bought this whole setup and bought this extension today because I needed to replace them. This handle will eventually break off, but I had a problem with the contacts not working, so I wasn't getting any power. So I threw that old situation away and bought a new one. Now, this is the good part. I only use my products from detailjuice.com. As you can see here, there is nothing in there that I do not manufacture. We've got the full lineup in there. I keep the accessory sprayer on the juice boost. If I want to put it in the bucket, I can. If not, I have the spray for direct to paint. I keep a, this is transform dressing. I need to mix up some more. This is the diluted infinite use detail juice. This is Tiger's Blood. This is Infinite Purpose Cleaner. I keep everything ready to go. I've got some Infinite Diamond Shield there. You know, I've got the whole works. Infinite Finish, Infinite Cut, the Perfect Soap. I rarely ever use that on a mobile job. I got Chrome Cream, Vitality Shield, Transform Dressing, Infinite Purpose Cleaner. I got Magnum Motorcycle Juice. Infinite Use Detail Juice, obviously, and then like I mentioned, Juice Boost. If I'm doing a boat, I'll throw in my marine products. Aqua Blocker generally is in here. I sell a lot of Aqua Blocker jobs. Okay, so the other mandatory piece of equipment, especially if it is in the summertime, is my cooler. I take a roller cooler. That way, if I'm going away from my truck, I can take it with me. I actually take this cooler on the boat a lot, so it's rusted a little bit or whatever. But anyway, it works really well, and it keeps ice for at least the day that I'm working, and that's really all I care about. It's hot as shit in the summertime here in Tampa, Florida, so I gotta make sure that I'm hydrated, or you will get no production out of me. So, that's a mandatory piece of equipment. I generally will keep that in the cab of my truck. Now on to the two other things that I would suggest. Now, you notice that my full bed, I've got a bed situation right there where I'm blocking everything from going into the bed. But I've got all of that room inside the bed. If I needed more equipment or if I had to bring a generator, which is what I'm trying to mention to you now, is if you need a generator or more water, especially in a rental situation, I buy these. This actually came from Northern Tool. You can get water containers anywhere. This is just a 5 gallon portable water tank, and you know, you'll get 5 car washes out of that one container, and look how small it is. It's just bigger than my cooler. You could fit, I mean, I don't know what kind of vehicle you drive, but you could fit one of those behind your back seat in your car, 2 of those. So you can get 10 cars done with that. That's a lot of cars. Couple other things that I will sometimes throw in there. If I'm doing a lot of cars, I use these spray deals. I get these things from Home Depot. I actually extended the hose a little bit. I think that this 2 gallon was like $15. But this I keep Tiger's Blood in. I have one that I keep Infinite Purpose Cleaner in, and the other one I keep Infinite Use Detail Juice in. I always carry the one with Infinite Use Detail Juice in it, and it is in my garage somewhere. But anyway, I always carry the Infinite Use Detail Juice sprayer. That's important for your pre-soak for your Garry Dean wash method. But there could be up to 3 of those in my truck at any given time, but there's always the one. This I use for wheels, Infinite Purpose Cleaner. Very similar situation, sometimes heavier soiled interiors, I'll use the IPC. But the cleaners don't always go because those little spray bottles work just fine. So, let's talk about generators. Now, I have had many generators in my time. And if you don't have the money to buy what I'm about to recommend to you, I would recommend you don't buy anything until you can afford it. You'll make one purchase one time. It's $1,000, but it's a Honda EU2000i generator. That generator will power the vacuum that I have and a polisher simultaneously with no issues at all day long. It sips gas. It runs forever. It's a Honda. I had one, and you know, I wasn't using it, and then I built a trailer around it, and then I sold the trailer with the generator because the generator was the only one that would fit how I built it, and you could lock it in. So I got rid of that. But beyond that, I have a camper, and the AC in the camper, the Honda wouldn't run it, so I had to get a bigger inverter generator for that. So I bought a Briggs & Stratton P3000, which is what I have now. I bought it on Amazon. I think it was $1,300. But for just detailing, and you don't need it for anything else, I would highly recommend the Honda EU2000i. The Honda EU1000 will not run the vacuum at all. I have tested that. It will not run this vacuum by itself. Let alone what the 2000 will do is run, you know, a polisher. If you've got one person working on one car on the outside, you got another person dealing with vacuuming out cars, it will run both of those simultaneously. So you need the Honda EU2000i, not the 1000, and you don't need the 3000. There's no reason for that. If you were going to get a larger setup than this, I feel like you're wasting money, you're wasting space, whatever. Do your thing. But this literally will do anything and everything I need it to do to make my customer happy about 99% of the time, period. You could also throw in a gazebo, a 10x10, 12x12 gazebo if you want to stay out of the sun. I have found that with a rinseless method, like the Garry Dean wash method, and then I, you know, I'll wear a nice a big floppy hat, that it's so efficient and so time saving that I can get in and out washing one panel at a time and make the customer happy with that and never have to set up a gazebo. I feel like that's a waste of time, especially when you've got jobs lined up. Wear a long sleeve moisture wicking shirt to stay out of the sun. Wear a big floppy hat, wear sunglasses, especially if it's in the summertime. But that's kind of what I'm getting at is, you know, I don't carry a gazebo because I never want to spend the time setting it up. I actually cool myself down by wearing things that keep me out of the sun, which is the exact same thing a gazebo would do, but it saves time throwing on a hat. And I always wear long sleeve moisture wicking shirts. Now I used to wear short sleeve shirts, then I get a crazy farmer's tan and all that, and none of that matters except for the moisture wicking shirts that I wear. They keep me out of the sun, so and they help me to breathe and to keep me cooler. So I protect me instead of putting the gazebo up to protect the car. Especially, you know, it matters most that you're washing one panel at a time where the sun's not going to dry the solution on the panel before you get to the next one. That's the biggest benefit of the rinseless wash in direct sunlight, is that you're not doing the whole car. You don't have to worry about the potential for water spots and that kind of thing, because by the time you wash the car, you're going right back in to dry the car and you're moving to the next section, so you don't have to worry about water spots. So that's pretty cool. But anyway, that's where we're at. That's what we got. That's my mobile setup. Again, if I had to put my generator in there, I can just put it in the back there if I needed, you know, a bunch of water. And realistically, you'd be hard-pressed to do more than 5 cars in a day by yourself anyway. So 5 gallons of water, run, you know, take 2 of those if you need to, just for extra water to mix product or whatever. You know, I've got my pre-mixed stuff, and then I've got my concentrate bottles so that I can make more if I need to. You know, having an extra 5-gallon container of water wouldn't be a bad idea. I'm talking about beyond the one that you're dedicating for your washes, because you always need a little extra water. But if you guys got any questions for me, please use my cell phone number is 813-846-4406. I'm sure that you're tired of hearing the cell phone number. You probably all have it memorized by now, but I'm serious. It's important to me that if you value what I'm doing and you would like for, you know, me to shed some light on what you're doing to try to help you grow your detailing business, or even if you're an enthusiast and would like my help, send me a text message. I'll get back to you. If it warrants a phone call, then we'll work that out as well. But I would love to help you in your detailing endeavors. That is what I'm here for. I believe that is my mission. That is my purpose in this industry now, is to help people in their detailing endeavors. I've already proven this stuff works. I've already, you know, had success in it, and now I'm trying to pay it forward and help you guys as much as I can. So again, if you got any questions, please let me know. And I appreciate you guys for watching these videos. I know I'm long-winded sometimes. Check out Garry Dean's Detail Juice Nation. It's a group on Facebook where we talk about only my products. And check out DetailJuice.com. That's my personal product line. My products, in my opinion, and the opinion of many, many other people, are the best products on the face of the planet. So give those a shot. If you got any questions for me, 813-846-4406. Thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful day. Catch you next time.